What is up, mi gente? Can you believe the readathon is starting next week already? I am so excited, and I'm here to give you some recs for the romance readathon. Although the focus is historical romance, all genres are welcome. You can learn more about it in my quick announcement video, including how to sign up, all the different teams, the best team, which is the team I'm co-leading, and how to get connected to our Discord and more. Because I love fantasy so freaking much, my video is actually gonna give you some historical romance and regular romance fantasy recs. If you want more recs or different types of recs, I have linked other booktubers that are doing TBR videos and rec videos down below. And I just want to highlight my co-lead, Mama Needs to Read Romance. She is the historical romance queen, strictly historical romance. Her recs are going to be incredible for this readathon. So starting with historical romance fantasy, I did not think I loved this genre so much until I started making this list and I realized how many of these fall under historical romance. I want to start with Anatomy and Immortality. These are books that I keep talking about so freaking much, and this is a perfect time to read them because it's set in Edinburgh during the 1800s. If you love that trope of different classes, of she's rich and he's poor, but does true love prevail? This is for you. It has a little bit of a Frankenstein twist. You'll know what I mean at the end of book one, and book two is even better. Another book I keep talking about is Divine Rivals. It was so freaking amazing. This is more low fantasy. There isn't a ton of magic in this, so if you're barely getting into fantasy and you don't really want all these crazy names and crazy world building, I would say Divine Rivals is for you. It also has enemies to lovers, the best forced proximity I've seen thus far, and such a beautiful, enchanting romance between our two characters. I just loved it so much. It made me feel giddy. It was so tasteful and beautiful and elegant. Highly recommend you to pick up Divine Rivals. This next one I have wanted to read so much, so it's also on my list to read if I can place another hold at the library, and it's The Time Traveler's Wife. I have not read the book, but I have seen the movie, and I heard the book is so much deeper and will make you cry completely. So I am looking forward to picking this book up as well. It's a man who has this issue in his genes, and he time jumps without wanting to. So during some really key moments in his life, he'll just boom, disappear. But that actually is how he met his wife. He accidentally went back in time and saw her when she was a young kid. Nothing creepy, don't worry, nothing like that. They started chatting, and she basically knew she would one day meet her husband at a specific spot. Couldn't wait to meet him when they were finally of age. And then it shows you their journey together, which is filled with so much tragedy and so much beauty. I really love the movie, and I really want to read the book. The next one I've heard so much about is Revel. Revel actually takes place in the Prohibition era, where a family might lose their whole club because of the Prohibition, but in comes this swaggering, super rich, sort of suspicious character, and their romance is either gonna make or break her family's business. So I heard really good things about this. So if you love a Prohibition era romance, this book might be for you. It's definitely in my TBR, and I hope the library will lend it to me soon. Also, I apologize if my voice sounds a little bit weird. I do have a bit of a sore throat, and also all the biking and stuff we did this past weekend has just really messed up my sense of hearing and speaking so loud. Here I go. So pardon my voice. Another top read is Clockwork Angel. I'm so excited to finally start this series, and it's been recommended that I start with Clockwork Angel. I had no idea that it's set in England, and this girl boards a ship to find her brother, ends up in this whole fantasy-like scenario with an underground community, an underground secret society called Shadow Hunters. So it's very fantasy, action-like, also filled with a lot of romance. I've heard it has some of the most heartbreaking romantic scenes that's happened. So if that type of setting is for you, like it is for me, I highly recommend you pick it up. And maybe we can read this one together throughout August. Next up, we have Stalking Jack the Ripper. Very similar to Anatomy, it has a character who wants to be in the forensic sciences. It has another character who really gets on her nerves, isn't sure if she would actually go for him or not. There's definitely wittiness and banter in Stalking Jack the Ripper, and they are literally trying to find the notorious Jack the Ripper in this book. So definitely falls under historical romance. The author actually throws in real victim names in there and real scenarios, and there is a chapter at the end that actually explains what was fully true and what she had to amend for the sake of the story. But it was really cool, and I look forward to reading the second book of this series. Now, one of my top unexpected reads was actually Serpent and Dove. This is like peak romanticy, but it is actually also considered a historical romance because it is set during a time period where women really don't have rights. The technology is very basic. Again, it's not super high fantasy, but I would say it's like low to mid fantasy because there are magic systems in place. I also dive more into a lot of these in my Books and Blush videos, so you can find them linked on my channel under the playlist Books and Blush. I have placed every single cover in the front so you can easily find it and you can know more there. And lastly, this was also so unexpected for me, is Belladonna. Belladonna is actually considered a romantic historical thriller, fantasy book. It has a little bit of everything. It is a gothic dark romance. I was living for the character in there that is literally death himself. So I loved it so much. I was really surprised by how I was squealing. There's a love triangle in there, and it's done in such a great way. It's not cheesy or annoying. There's no annoying breakup or torn where she's just going back and forth when it's an obvious answer. It's actually a really fun love triangle that I haven't seen for a while. So again, dark gothic romance. If that is your cup of tea, I would recommend this one. And the fantasy world isn't so high, and it's also in a historical setting, of course. Now I just want to highlight some romanticy. I adore romanticy. It's basically fantasy and romance. A lot of times people will say romantic fantasy and romanticy are different because one highlights the romance more, the other highlights the action and fantasy more. So you decide based on what I tell you about these books. August 1st is actually the release date of Bring Me Your Midnight. Bring Me Your Midnight was a really beautiful atmospheric tale. If you want something more cozy, more about the main character journeying and finding herself, this book is for you. It's all pure vibes, ocean, island, water, nature, very connected to the earth, purely atmospheric. I think the author is very well known for writing atmospheric books, so I recommend this book if that is your cup of tea, which there actually is a whole magic system in here about cups of tea. I cannot make this list without mentioning Fourth Wing, the thing that has taken me over completely. I adore Fourth Wing, romanticy to its finest degree. I adore it so much. If you love dragons, enemies to lovers, definitely way more high fantasy in this than the other books I have mentioned, because there's a whole world, the dragons speak, there are a lot of battles, a lot of siphons and powers. Fortunately, the names are not super crazy, and there's nothing that is super new to us, except it just looks like our world and it has some elements of fantasy. But it is super awesome. I don't really get fictional crushes that easy, but Zayden Ryerson was definitely my new addition to the three fictional characters that I crush on. That's saying a lot, because he made it onto my list where it was previously just one character that I crushed on. So I definitely recommend you read Fourth Wing. I know it's backtracked, but this would be a perfect time for you to read it and get obsessed over it and basically have a book hangover, and then we can decide how to help you and resurrect you out of your reading slump. Now, this next one I have heard so much about, and I'm surprised I didn't read it back in the early 2000s. It is Shatter Me. Shatter Me, I've heard people become so freaking obsessed over it. They just love it so much because of the romance and the ships that happen in this series. I was actually so surprised to hear that the author even made three more books after like 5 years or a decade of not publishing more within this world. I'm really surprised I haven't read it, because it falls in that Twilight era. This did not cross my path at all, even though it looks familiar. So I really look forward to reading this one as well, and I recommend it to you if you are a big romanticy fan. Now, this last romanticy rec I actually recommended to Mama Needs to Read Romance. I told you guys that I picked two books up from her recs, but one of them she specifically specifically recommended to me. I'm gonna try a pure historical romance novel for the first time with the step back and everything, and she is going to try a romanticy rec that I gave her. I actually picked Once Upon a Broken Heart for her because this book is pure romanticy. When I tell you I read this book, I was like, this is a romance novel. This is a fairy tale romanticy novel. Stephanie Garber is considered our modern fairy tale creator. Her books read like they really would be a fairy tale from back in the day, but our main character Evangeline is so sweet and so good-hearted, and I think it gives some sense of coziness in the book, whereas our love interest Jax is sort of anti-villainish and definitely morally gray, if not straight up just a villain, but there's that softness in him that drive all of us madly in love with him. Okay, we love Jax. This book is definitely way more fantasy because there are a lot of quirky things that happen in this world that is more fantastical. And if you've heard about the series Caravelle, this is the spin-off because we focus really on Jax. He became such a favorite of the fandom that Stephanie Garber had to write his spin-off story, and here we are. The third one is set to release this year, so there are two books out so far, and that is the first. Highly, highly recommend. If you really want to understand what pure romanticy is, where it's just really romance, this book would be for you. And what better time than during the romance readathon? You guys, I am so excited. If you didn't know, we are also gonna have reading sprints for the first time ever. I'm gonna live stream on my channel if I figure out how to do that, or I'm gonna have other booktubers joining my lives as well. Please join. You don't have to turn on your camera. We're gonna be interacting on there, reading. I'm gonna hopefully have some games prepared so we interact within that hour-ish. I hope one of these books got on your TBR and you are as excited as I am for this romance readathon and to meet other amazing booktubers. Check out again the link below and other videos I have on some of these books so you get a better sense of them. This was a quick recap video and rec video. I cannot wait to interact with more of you over on Discord. If you like this and you want to be part of that next live, make sure you hit subscribe, comment, like, do all of that good stuff. Now I'm off to finally see the Barbie movie. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video and in my first ever live next week. Bye!